You may delay, but time will not. Good morning, today is Friday, January 12, 2024. Today in history, French writer Charles Perrault was born 396 years ago today. He gathered oral stories from French folk, creating renowned works like Cinderella, Little Red Riding Hood, and Sleeping Beauty in the Woods. Perrault is hailed as the founder of the fairy tale genre and is recognized as the father of French children's literature, making him a prominent figure in 17th-century French literature. Ching Chiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Ching Chiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. South Korea passes bill to ban eating dog meat. Agence France-Presse reports that the South Korean parliament has passed a dog meat ban bill during a recent plenary session. The bill prohibits the raising, slaughtering, and selling of dogs for food. Violators may face up to 3 years in prison or a fine of up to 30 million won for slaughtering, and up to 2 years in prison or a fine of up to 20 million won for raising, breeding, and selling. The law, effective from 2027, includes a buffer period to allow the industry to phase out. The law, effective from 2027, includes a buffer period to allow the industry to phase out. CARA, a South Korean animal rights organization, sees this as a groundbreaking moment for the animal rights movement. However, the Korean Meat Dog Association argues that the government lacks sufficient compensation measures for dog meat practitioners, vowing to fight for their rights. Some even claim that following the closure of dog meat farms, up to 2 million food dogs could be released near the official residences of the president and the Minister of Agriculture, Forestry, Livestock, and Food. Government data indicates 1,150 dog farms, 34 slaughterhouses, 219 distributors, and around 1,600 restaurants in South Korea involved in the dog meat industry. A December 2023 survey of 2,000 Korean adults revealed that 94.5% hadn't consumed dog meat in the past year, and 93.4% expressed they wouldn't in the future. French president appoints new prime minister. Recent Lien Hazaobao News reports a notable change in French leadership, with Gabriel Attal becoming the new prime minister under President Macron. Born in 1989, Attal, at 34 years old, holds a diverse political background, having served in various roles, including Secretary of State for Universal Civil Service, Secretary of State for French Youth Affairs, and Ministerial Representative for Public Accounts. From 2020 to 2022, he also served as the government spokesman, and in July 2023, he assumed the position of France's Minister of National Education and Youth. Remarkably, Attal is now the youngest prime minister in modern French history and the first openly gay head of government in the country. Former Prime Minister Bornet resigned a few days ago, submitting her resignation to President Macron. Bornet's tenure was marked by efforts to pass controversial bills on retirement system reform and immigration in the parliament. While the new prime minister's appointment may not alter enacted policies, it signifies Macron's quest for a fresh perspective to rebuild public confidence. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. U.S. troops refuse to leave Iraq. According to recent information from Washington, U.S. Air Force Major General Patrick S. Ryder stated that the United States currently has no plans to withdraw approximately 2,500 troops from Iraq. There has been no notification from Iraq to the Department of Defense regarding any withdrawal. He emphasized that the U.S. military, invited by the Iraqi government to combat the Islamic State, remains highly focused on the mission to fight against extremist terrorist organizations like ISIS. In a prior incident, the United States deployed a drone to eliminate a leader of the pro-Iranian Shia militia Popular Mobilization Forces in Baghdad, causing heightened tensions in U.S.-Iran relations. Iraqi Prime Minister Sudani condemned the action as a blatant aggression against Iraq, demanding the swift withdrawal of the international coalition led by the United States from Iraq, expressing a resolute stance with no intention of retreating. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Cambodia attracts $4.9 billion investment in 2023. As per the Cambodia-China Times, The latest report from the Development Council of Cambodia reveals that in 2023, they greenlit 268 investment projects, totaling around $4.9 billion in agreed investments, generating roughly 307,000 jobs. This marks a substantial 22% increase from 2022. Notably, 92% of these projects, numbering 248, were in the industrial sector, representing approximately 46% of the total investment. Agriculture saw 9 projects, experiencing a 115.8% increase in investment compared to the previous year, while the tourism sector had 4 projects, facing a 69% decline in investment. Geographically, most projects are concentrated in Sapa Prairie Province, Phnom Penh City, and nearby provinces such as Kandal, Takao, Svay Riang, and Sihanoukville, which host special economic zones. China led in investments with a 66% share, followed by local Cambodian investment at 24%, while Singapore and Malaysia each contributed 2%. Now, here is some important safety information. Loose door bolts found on multiple Boeing aircraft. In recent New York news, an Alaska Airlines 737 MAX 9, in service for only 8 weeks, experienced a detached, sealed door on the left side shortly after taking off from Portland, Oregon. This led to a sudden depressurization, prompting an emergency return. U.S. authorities swiftly ordered the grounding of the aircraft for a comprehensive safety inspection. United Airlines currently operates 79 such aircraft, and initial inspections revealed nearly 10 with loose bolts. The Federal Aviation Administration mandated a series of inspections, covering left and right door components, plugs, and fasteners, before allowing the aircraft back into service. A prominent aviation analyst suggested the issue may be a quality control matter rather than a flaw in the airframe design. Boeing might encounter delays in approvals for new jetliners or proposed maintenance programs. Beyond the U.S., numerous global regulatory agencies and airlines have also ordered the grounding of Boeing 737 MAX 9. Boeing's stock experienced an 8% drop on Monday, marking its most significant decline since October 2022. Ecuador enters a state of internal armed conflict. Ecuadorian media reports indicate that the recent escape of drug lord Adolfo Macias from a prison in the southwest has triggered riots in 6 local prisons, leading to the detention of several prison guards by inmates. Subsequently, a shooting occurred near the presidential palace in Ecuador, prompting National Assembly to issue an emergency evacuation order. Armed clashes have also erupted in subway stations and universities in Guayaquil, the country's second-largest city, with all shopping malls and hospitals placed on the highest alert. Evacuations were carried out in many markets and parks, while various transportation systems and urban arterial lines were suspended. Facing this crisis, Ecuadorian President Daniel Noboa signed an executive decree declaring the country in a state of internal armed conflict. The decree identifies 22 organized criminal groups as terrorist organizations and non-state belligerents, instructing the armed forces to operate within the framework of international humanitarian law. The security situation in Ecuador is reported to be dire. In August 2023, presidential candidate Fernando Villavicencio was fatally shot while attending an election rally in the north of the capital, Quito. President Guillermo Lasso declared a 60-day state of emergency across the country. In November 2023, Noboa assumed the presidency, making security a top priority for the government. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Filipino Catholics worship Black Jesus in mass gathering. The Philippine Dragon Media Network reported that recently, hundreds of thousands of Catholics in the Philippines gathered in the streets of Manila to worship the Black Jesus statue. Many Filipinos believe that being near or touching this over 400-year-old, life-size, wooden statue can cure stubborn illnesses and bring good luck. The Black Jesus Day is commemorated as a special non-working holiday in Manila on January 9, as declared by Philippine President Bongbong Marcos. Around 80% of the Philippines' 110 million people follow Roman Catholicism, and the Black Nazarene is a highly significant religious celebration in Manila. Its origin dates back to 1606 when Spanish missionaries, transporting the statue of Jesus from Mexico to the Philippines, encountered a ship fire. Despite the fire, the statue of Jesus remained, acquiring a blackened appearance. Believers saw this as a manifestation, and since then, Filipinos have paraded the statue every January 9th, with tens of thousands participating in the event. Financial newsletter. As reported by the Securities Times, the spot price of battery-grade lithium carbonate has recently dropped to 98,000 yuan per ton, falling below the 100,000 yuan per ton threshold. Research reports from various brokerages suggest that the subsequent spot price for battery-grade lithium carbonate is expected to continue fluctuating and weaken, possibly dropping below 80,000 yuan per ton. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.